The atmosphere is held down by gravity. It exerts a force upon every surface. Pressure is actually defined as force per unit area. At sea level, the average approximate weight of the column of air above a surface with 1 centimeter cross-section is 1 kilogram. That is approximately 15 pounds per inch cross-section. The normal standardized sea level pressure can be expressed in different ways. It can be expressed as 760 millimeter of mercury, or 29.921 inches of mercury, or 1013.25 millibar, or 1013.25 hectopascal. All these numbers refer to the same normal standardized sea level pressure. The highest sea level pressure ever measured was 1084 millibar. It was in winter 1968 in Siberia. The lowest was 870 millibar in 1979 in a Western Pacific typhoon. Air pressure can be measured with a mercury barometer or an aneroid barometer. Aneroid means without fluid, which is basically a collapsible chamber which compresses proportionally to air pressure. Air pressure decreases exponentially with altitude. It halves approximately every 5.5 kilometers or 3.5 miles. All air pressure measurements at weather stations need to be reduced to sea level pressure equivalents to facilitate a horizontal comparison of pressures. If the surface air pressure in a certain region is relatively high, we call this a high pressure system or an anticyclone. By definition, the surrounding air of anticyclones is characterized by relatively low pressure. Anticyclones are characterized by descending air and divergence. Descending means sinking air. Descending air warms, causes the evaporation of clouds, and creates clear skies. Divergence refers to air flowing away from a high pressure system. It is the net horizontal outflow of air. A cyclone is a low pressure system. The surrounding air of a cyclone has relatively high pressure. Cyclones are characterized by ascending air and convergence. Ascending means rising. Ascending air cools and leads to the formation of clouds and possibly precipitation. Convergence refers to the fact that air is coming together in the low pressure center, so we're talking about a net horizontal inflow of air. Horizontal variations of air pressure are depicted on weather maps by isobars. An isobar is a line of equal barometric pressure on a weather map. The amount of pressure change occurring over a given distance is called pressure gradient. A weak pressure gradient is depicted by widely spaced isobars. A steep or strong pressure gradient is depicted by closely spaced isobars. Wind is the horizontal or vertical movement of air. Horizontal wind is the result of horizontal differences in air pressure. The air flows always from higher pressure towards lower pressure. Wind speed is measured by an anemometer. Wind direction is measured by a wind vane. The naming always refers to the direction from which the winds originate. For example, westerly winds blow eastward. The horizontal movement of air is affected by three forces: the pressure gradient force, the Coriolis force, and the friction force. Unequal heating of the Earth's surface causes high and low pressure areas in the atmosphere, and with this, the pressure gradient. The pressure gradient force is the cause of wind. It drives the wind directly from areas with higher barometric pressure to areas with lower atmospheric pressure. The pressure gradient force acts at right angles to the isobars. Steep pressure gradients cause high wind speeds. The following illustration should help you understand the Coriolis effect. Two points having the same longitude will travel together as the Earth rotates. Even though the two points are traveling together, the point nearer the equator travels a greater distance and thus must move faster. Now consider a projectile launched from the equator towards a target located at 40 degrees north, the red circle. Instead of traveling due north, the red line, to the target, the projectile appears to move towards the right, the yellow line, because it is actually traveling faster to the east than the red dot. The Coriolis force is the deflecting force of the Earth's rotation. A moving object is apparently deflected to the right from its original course in the northern hemisphere. A moving object on the southern hemisphere is deflected to the left. The explanation for this phenomenon is the inertia of the object, which means that the object retains its original radial component of the movement. The Coriolis force depends on the latitude and the speed. A higher latitude causes a stronger deflection of the movement. The Coriolis force is zero at the equator and takes on a maximum at the poles. A higher wind speed causes a stronger deflection. Pressure gradient and Coriolis force are in a balance. The combination of pressure gradient and Coriolis force causes the wind to flow parallel to the isobars. This occurs in reality in the upper troposphere. Winds that flow parallel to the isobars are called geostrophic winds. Friction is a force of opposition which slows down air in motion. It is initiated at the surface and decreases with altitude. It depends on the roughness of the surface. Smooth surfaces such as short grass will exert small friction forces. Rough surfaces such as forests or urban landscapes will exert large friction forces. The part of the atmosphere where winds are affected by friction is called the planetary boundary layer. It extends to approximately 1 mile off the surface. Due to the fact that friction reduces wind speed, it also reduces the Coriolis deflection. The result is that the pressure gradient force overpowers the Coriolis effect and winds will flow across the isobars. Previously, it was shown that the surface winds will cross the isobars at an angle towards lower pressure. But how does this determine the direction air flows around high and low pressure systems? By orienting four of the parallel isobar models with the higher pressure sides inward, a closed high pressure system is formed. Now each of the parcel trajectory suggests the wind direction in that location. Therefore, air flows away from a high pressure system in a clockwise manner. Explaining the winds around a low pressure system can be accomplished in a similar way. By orienting four of the parallel isobar models with the lower pressure sides inward, a closed low pressure system is formed. Now each of the parcel trajectory suggests the wind direction in that location. Therefore, air flows in toward a low pressure system in a counterclockwise manner. The result of the three forces affecting wind directions is the cyclonic and anticyclonic flow around a low and high pressure system. In the northern hemisphere, cyclones spiral counterclockwise and inward, convergence. Anticyclones spiral clockwise and outward, divergence. The directions in the southern hemisphere are opposite. Here is one more illustration showing you the forces affecting the movement of air parcels. If there is only pressure gradient force, the parcels will move straight towards the low pressure system. If there is pressure gradient and Coriolis force, the parcels will move along the isobars. Pressure gradient, Coriolis and friction causes the air parcels to move across the isobars at an angle toward the low pressure.